Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/I don't work here, lady. Our first story is, I work here, officer. But before we start, if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Back in the mid-2000s, I was working as a substitute teacher at an inner-city school district. I'd been subbing for a few weeks, but it was the first time at the Votech school. The school had a policy where if a student was in the halls without a pass, they'd be arrested and brought to the office. There it would be checked to see if they were supposed to be, then released and either sent on their way with a pass or sent to detention. If they weren't a student, they'd be brought downtown. The school had issues with students from other schools coming in during the day and causing trouble. So one of my scheduled classes had no students, and the neighboring teachers both confirmed that I did indeed have the correct class, and it was the correct week. So instead of having one of the teachers call down, because they did have classes, I decided to just walk down to the office myself. I'd gone about 20 feet when the school resource officer saw me. He decided to check for my hall pass, a document I didn't possess, so he started the arrest process. As he was leading me down to the office, I wasn't handcuffed or anything, I pointed out several issues with his assumption. I possessed a school substitute schedule with my name on it, the name did match my driver's license, and the driver's license confirmed that I was 24. In a building where everyone but the principal and the police officer were in casual clothes or work jumpsuits, I was in business casual, with a tie. The neighboring teachers could confirm that I was a substitute. He refused to check my license and confiscated my stolen schedule. He also refused to disrupt class unnecessarily. We made it down to the office about 5 minutes later. When we walked in, the head secretary asked, "Oh, Mr. Hip Hop, how's your first day teaching?" As I started to answer, she then said, "Officer, police officer, what brings you down here again?" To which he replied, "Oh, just getting another coffee," with a red face. Technically, he never dropped the charges on me. Sounds like a great way to make sure kids never learn to trust authorities. That's not my tanker truck, lady. Just discovered this sub, and holy lutefisk dinner, have I got a doozy from a couple months ago. Short backstory. I just got off a 14-hour shift. I work for a utility company. And this took place about 5 a.m. in a smaller suburb of the Twin Cities in January. I stopped for gas at the local Stop and Rob and a few snacks for my upcoming shift at 2 p.m. Another 14-hour shift. Lots of overtime. I pull into the station, and the tanker truck is there for a delivery. I get out, fuel up my run-of-the-mill boring box on wheels, and start to go into the store. About 5 feet from the entrance, I hear a slight squealing of tires and watched a monstrosity of an SUV, Lincoln Navigator, I think, roar around the tanker and park about 1 foot behind it. I was already beat tired and didn't really think anything of it since people do drive a little nuts around here. I'm in the store looking at what kind of garbage I can eat for the next day and maybe a couple energy drinks for later that night. This is when the fun begins. M is me, CL is crazy lady, SD is sheriff's deputy. CL:
Hey, you.
Me: I turn around to look at a lady staring right at me. CL:
You need to move your truck.
I had kind of a puzzled look on my face.
Yes, I'm talking to you. You need to move your truck now.
I point at the salt-crested SUV at pump number 5. You mean that car?
No, the tanker truck. It's blocking the tire pump. My tire light's on and I need to fill it up now. I'm in a big hurry.
Funny thing is, those little tire fillers have like a 20-foot retractable hose on them. That's not my semi.
I just watched you walk in, like 30 seconds ago.
Well, that's not my truck. I'm now beginning to wonder why she thought I was the truck driver. We probably have on the same high-vis yellow coats with silver reflective stripes that's just as common as blaze orange during deer season. That's not my truck. I don't work here, and you can get the hell away from me. At this point, one of the local sheriff's deputies walks in right before I say, "Get the hell away from me." I see them here quite a bit in the morning to get coffee. The police officer walks over and asks if there's a problem.
This guy needs to move his truck. It's blocking the tire pump. I'm in a big hurry and one of my tires is low.
I tell the police officer, my car's over there on pump 5. I don't know why this lady thinks I'm the semi driver. At this point, I'm wondering where the semi driver is, either in the back office doing paperwork or destroying one of the toilets in the restroom. So the police officer says to the crazy lady, "Okay, show me what you're talking about."
They both go outside and walk to the back of the tanker truck. I pay for my gas and snacks, and here comes the truck driver out of the restroom. He's probably going to need a power washing. As I'm walking out to my car, I see the deputy pointing to the back of her car, and they were talking about something. I couldn't hear them. So the police officer and crazy lady walked back inside the store just as the truck driver was walking out. And yeah, he was wearing a similar high-vis coat. I put the snacks in my car, and now curiosity has struck me, so I walk over to the crazy lady's SUV and saw that it has whiskey plates on them. Maybe it's her, maybe it's her husband's, I don't know. Then I saw it. I couldn't believe my eyes. The license plate showed October 2018. They were 14 months expired. So I got a good laugh from that, and I hope the crazy lady got a ticket for expired tags. I went home and got some rest. Karen got what she had coming. Today, I got a message from an old IT consultancy colleague of mine who runs his own small consultancy firm now. He was looking for someone who can hold his own winky face for one of his clients, which reminded me of this story. Background: about 10 years ago, I was fresh out of college and started working for an IT consultancy firm. The first assignment I got was at a huge international company, which site in my country had about 100 people working for them. Half of them were consultants from my employer, the other half were internal employees. I joined a small development team, also half consultants and half internals. On site, there was a service manager from my employer who oversaw all consultants when it came to evaluations, bonuses, news from our employer, etc. The consultants reported to a manager from the company for work-related stuff, but to the service manager from our employer for HR-related stuff. This story takes place in the beginning of January, and I just transitioned from consultant to internal employee after working with the client for a year and a half. Characters: me is me, Ross is the big boss, the manager from the company slash client, Karen's the service manager, conveniently named Karen, Greg is good guy Greg, my colleague, the one who messaged me today. Story: I was on a conference call with Ross, Greg, and some people from a different site. Me, Ross, and Greg were all sitting in a different location in the building. It was one of those meetings where you listen for an hour and only speak at the end to say bye. I had my noise-canceling headphones with microphone on, which had the company's logo on it. Ross gave it to me when I signed the contract with the company, as it was a leftover from the Christmas presents they all got. Suddenly, Karen yanks the headphones off my head and starts yelling, "Answer me instead of listening to music, you effing weasel!" I just sat there with my mouth open in shock as I hadn't seen or heard her approaching me. "And who the hell did you steal these headphones from? These are for internals only." "But, they're mine." Due to the initial shock, I couldn't find the words to explain I got transitioned to internal when she was on her month-long holiday in December, and clearly she didn't get the memo. "Stop lying to me, turd! Consider your butt fired!" I find my composure back and say, "You can't fire me. I don't work for you. And even if I did, you have no right to talk to me like that." At this point, my phone beeped. I glanced at my screen and saw a message from Greg. "You are not on mute. Ross and I can hear the whole thing. You are a lying piece of crap. Stop looking at your phone when I'm talking to you." "I don't work for you anymore. And if you keep talking to me like that, I will call security to have you removed." "Who the F do you think?" She was interrupted by her own phone ringing, which apparently was a call from Ross. She answers her phone with all the fake jolliness she could muster after the tirade against me, but after that, all I heard was, "Oh, no, sir. And yes, sir." Maybe I have to note that Ross, my manager, was the most senior manager on our site and therefore also the country manager who signed the contract with my old employer for which Karen worked. This was the only time in my life I saw someone age 20 years in a mere 15 seconds. Her face shifted from red to white as if someone flipped a light switch. She hung up and left without saying another word to me. Later, I found out people had complained about her behavior before, but now she was caught red-handed, and my manager made sure her services were not needed anymore. She also got fired from my old employer. As the company was their biggest contract, they couldn't afford to lose it due to Karen's actions. In some way, I had to thank her for it, though, as I haven't had any problems with shutting down someone who's being abusive since that event. I love reading stories where horrible people get a horrible outcome that they deserve. To think if she'd kept her cool and actually listened, maybe paid a bit of attention, she'd still have an effing job. and our next story. But you're in a uniform. Thought you might like another of my Aussie I don't work here lady experiences. On a side note, apologies for any grammatical or spelling errors. I'm enjoying a few beers at work when I thought it'd be a nice idea to post this. I've done worse things while drunk on a computer. For reference, I work in the mining industry. Classic Australian, am I right? And I have quite a technical profession. After finishing my swing away, I was elected democratically, with a North Korean style of democracy, to drive the work ute back to Perth. It's a 6-hour trip prior to going home. I pulled into one of its many large shopping centers wearing my work uniform, which consists of high-vis and steel caps. My shirt is bright fluorescent yellow with reflective tape running across the chest with the company logo, Dig a Big Hole Resources, emblazoned on the front of the shirt. I went to the shops to get a few things for dinner, but mainly beer, when I was approached by a woman asking to display my work lanyard at all times. I gave her a puzzled look and she asked if I was new and if I'd been inducted. I gave her a curious frown and asked, "Inducted for what?" I should have kept my mouth shut because the way she reacted was like I had vomited on the Pope. She started cussing me out, asking to speak to my boss and berating me about how all apprentices should be inducted prior to carrying out work in the center. I told her I'm not an apprentice and I certainly don't work here. Then she said the classic line, "But you're in a uniform." To which I replied, "I work for Dig a Big Hole Resources and I'm not an apprentice." Cue the awkward silence, followed by her best impersonation of a kookaburra. Needless to say, I enjoyed those beers that night slightly more, knowing that I had confused the F out of a mere mortal being confronted by a miner in Perth. Took me longer than it should have to figure out amorite isn't a mineral you guys mine in Australia. I think I better get some sleep. And I thank you all for watching the video to the end. I'll see you in the next one.